Hello students, through the slides we will be dealing with soil erosion control measures for agriculture lands and particularly about mechanical methods. Okay, in previous video lecture we saw some agronomical measures, okay, with the help of some vegetative measures with some plants and like that things we just control the soil erosion. In this slides we will be dealing with mechanical methods. Some kind of modification will be done in the soil. Okay, we can see one. So the there are four things we are going to see here. First one is contour bund and graded bunds, then broad beds and furrows, then basin listing and random tie ridging. Okay, these are the four things. And one more thing is this mechanical methods, it is also called as engineering methods. Okay, some kind of when I say engineering, it is some design will be there. Okay, suppose if you take this contour bund, we are going to design the bund, like length and width of the bund, then slope percentage, like that. When you do some calculations, then it is engineering measures. Okay, it is also known as mechanical measures to control soil erosion, and this is for plains. Okay, so bund, it is an embankment like structure. See here, there is an embankment like structure here, and it is constructed across the land slope. Okay, it is if the land slope is like this, then I am constructing across the land slope. Okay, so that it will control the when the water will be flowing along the slope. When it is constructed across the slope, it will be controlling the soil erosion as well as it will conserve the water. Okay, so there are two types of bund we are going to see. One is contour and another one is graded bund. So when I say it is contour, it is the line joining the points having same elevation. So when I construct a bund along the contour line, then it is a contour bund. Okay, then it is the contour bund. Suppose I am providing a grade. Grade is nothing but it is a slope. Okay, it is a slopey like thing. When I provide some grade for the bund, then it is called as graded bund. So the construction of bund, it depends upon rainfall, soil condition, then type of outlets, like that. It depends upon the three factors. Okay, so the major difference between contour and a graded bund is the contour bunds will be having it will be constructed in the areas having low rainfall, that is annual rainfall less than 600 mm, and also the soil should be a light textured soils. Okay, in those places we can go for contour bunds. So when there is high rainfall, we have to provide some grade. Okay, when I provide some grade, see here, see the pointer here, contour bund, it will be like this. Okay, along the contour. In graded bunds, we will be providing some grade, there will be some slope. Okay, there will be some slope like this even. Okay, so when you provide such grades, when there is more rainfall, if it is contour bund, what will happen is the bund will be washed away. Okay, bund is nothing but an embankment, no, with the help of earth, that is the soil, we are making some embankment. Okay, when there is more rainfall, and if there is no grade, then the bund will be collapsed. Okay, rainfall will just wash away the bunds. So to avoid that, in high rainfall areas, there will be some grade. Grade is slope. Likewise, from the top, it will be somewhat going down. Okay, some grade will be there. So that is called as graded bund. Then it is constructed in lands having slopes between 2 to 6%, and when the soil is poor, having poor permeability, we can go for graded bunds. Okay, then in graded bunds we have two types. One is uniform grade and another one is variable grade. Uniform grade is from starting till end there is same grade. Okay, same slope is there. Whereas in variable grade, when the length of the bund is more, okay, when there is a very long bund, at that time we cannot have the same grade. Okay, some places it will be, there will be some little slope, then there may be some higher slopes, again some little. Likewise, when there is variable grade, the grade is varying, that is called as variable graded bunds, and the bunds will be having more discharge. Okay, discharge will be more, it will be discharging more amount of water, whereas in uniform graded bunds it will be having discharge less. Discharge, when I say, it is nothing but water. Okay, when our main aim is to control the water, conserve the water and control the soil erosion. Okay, when there is more water is coming, then it will be just washing away the bunds. See in this picture, when there is more amount of water is coming, just it will be washing away the earthen bunds here. So to avoid those things, we are providing some grade here. Okay, when I provide grade, what happens, the water, it will be just moving towards the grade. Okay, it won't be stagnant, too much water won't be stagnating here, it will be just moving towards the lower elevation. Okay, that is called graded bunds and uniform and variable graded bunds. Okay, then broad beds and furrows. Broad beds and furrows, this is your broad bed. Okay, in field also you can see this is the broad bed. Then furrow is where the water is being discharged. Okay, and here you can grow plants, this is crops. Okay, can grow plants. So broad bed and furrows. So bed and furrow system has two main functions. One, it is erosion control, and another one is surface drainage. Okay, so the beds, it can be of different dimension, and this system is suitable for black soils. Okay, so bed, it is functioning as a mini bund. Okay, in the bund, like in the previous image we have seen, it is like a bund, mini bund. It reduces the velocity, whereas the excess water is removed through the furrows. Okay, you just imagine, in the previous image we have seen furrows for discharging the water, then bunds for controlling the erosion. Okay, so these are all some advantages of bed and furrow system. No land is taken out of production. Okay, then bed can be maintained easily by minimal tillage. Then surface of bed dries quickly, facilitating easy planting in the beds. Then soils on the bed is friable throughout cropping season. Okay, it is friable. So next one is basin listing. So we have a implement called basin lister. What this instrument implement does is, it will be scooping the soils. Okay, like ice cream scoops, it will be scooping the soils, and some basins are formed. Okay, in the field some basins are formed, then those basins are connected by a furrow. Okay, furrow. So to make this furrow, there is a furrower. Okay, furrower also will be attached to the tractor at the same time. So whenever we need a furrow, we are going to drop that furrower down, so it will be making a furrow in the soil. Okay, so at the same time we can make some basins as well as furrows. Okay, this is called basin listing methods, and this basin lister can be can work about 2 to 3 hectares a day in heavy soils. Okay, this will, the basins also, it is helping in soil erosion control as well as water conserving. Okay, so next one is random tie ridging. In random tie ridging, that word random is without any orderliness. Okay, that is random. So in random manner we are going to tie the ridges. Okay, ridges are formed with the help of soil, and the ridges are connected, tying is connecting. Okay, in a random manner we are just tying the, connecting the ridge, this basin, small basins. Now this basins, it is formed with the help of ridges, and this ridges are connected. Okay, it is tied to make the water to flow. Okay, so that it will be conserving the water as well as the erosion of soil also will be controlled. Okay, the last one is vegetative waterways. Waterways are the channels, it may be natural or constructed channels, through which water is flowing from one place to another say from the source to field. Okay, see in this image it is a water channel, okay, waterways. So when it is vegetative waterways, we are planting some erosion resistant grasses. Okay, when there is no grass, what happens is the soil will be getting eroded along with the flowing water. Another one drawback is the water will be seeping inside the soil. Okay, it will be percolating inside or seeping inside the soil. To avoid these two things, we are just planting some grasses. So this controls the erosion as well as controls the deep percolation of water. Okay, so this vegetative waterways also it is helpful in controlling our soil erosion. Okay, thank you. If you have any doubts, you can write to me.